Hello, massage nerds. Today I'm going to be doing skeletal system pathologies part two. I did part one last week, and there's just so many in each chapter that I want to make sure that, you know, I break them apart or separate them a little bit, because if not, the videos are way too long, and I know you guys are not going to sit through half an hour of pathology. So this is my attempt to do the second part. We're going to be talking about Lyme disease, osteoarthritis, osteoporosis, patellofemoral pain syndrome, rheumatoid arthritis, scoliosis, spondylosis, sprain, and temporomandibular disorders. So let's start with Lyme disease. Lyme disease is a recurring form of arthritis. It affects the joints, the skin, the nervous system. It's a bacteria that gets into your body usually by a tick bite. Massage is contraindicated if there's inflammation, systemic inflammation. Systemic inflammation means all over your system. So if there's systemic inflammation, you don't want to do any massage until the inflammation has gone down. And people that have, you know, Lyme disease, it does come and go. It flares up all of a sudden. And so you have to do a very good medical history and make sure that you update every time that they come in, that you ask them that, because, you know, it affects the larger joints and it can be very painful. You don't want to use a lot of pressure, and you do want to stay away if they're having a flare up. Okay, so that's Lyme disease. And remember, I'm just going to remind you real quick. Massage is contraindicated for any acute, you know, or chronic inflammation, obviously. So you always want to update every time your client comes in. You want to make sure that you ask them how they're feeling that day. Osteoarthritis, also known as OA, is, let's break down the word. Osteo means bone. Arthro means, you know, arthrosis is another word for joints. So itis is inflammation. So osteoarthritis is inflammation of the joint capsule and progressive joint, leading to loss of articular cartilage. Eventually it starts, you know, deteriorating, you know, the even down to the bone. This is seen, and it's common in injuries and repetitive motion. People that are obese or are, you know, sports injuries, sprains, dislocations, eventually they come back and haunt you. It also wear and tear of the joints. It affects, you know, mainly the hands, the wrists, even your spine, your hips, your larger joints first, and then the smaller joints also. So I recommend heat. I usually, with the people that have OA, I usually apply heat. It feels really good. Moist heat, the hydroculator, you know, my moist packs, I put them on their joints while let's say I'm working their neck and their hands are really hurting. So I put the hydroculator, the pads on their hands or their joints, their knee, their hips, their, you know, the wrist, whatever hurts. And it really makes a difference. And by the time I get to that area, it's a little bit more comfortable. You want to stay on three or four on a scale from 1 to 10. You want to stay at a 3. You don't want to use a lot of pressure because it can be very painful. And also remember, like in osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis, massage only alleviates the symptoms. It doesn't cure it. It doesn't make it go away. It just alleviates the symptoms in between for when they come see you. So next is osteoporosis. Osteo, again, that's the root word, that's bone. Porosis is that, you know, it becomes porous. And what it is loss of bone density. The spongy bone becomes very thin, and the compact bone becomes porous. Porous meaning like it has holes. It is very common in women, elderly women. 80% of them are women. It happens in the elderly. You know, falls is a common thing that happens with osteoporosis. You know, I was reading an article the other day that actually mentioned that some people have such severe osteoporosis that sometimes the bone crumbles, and that's what causes the person to fall. it's not necessarily a fall causes the break, but the bone is so porous that it'll cause the elderly, you know, to fall. So it's common in the wrists, the hips. You want to do light pressure for sure, especially around the ribs. You don't want to go too deep. Definitely nothing deep tissue. Stay within the comfort level of the client. 3 out of 10. Make sure your client is comfortable. A lot of times their bones, you know, really do ache and they hurt, especially if they're elderly. They might not be able to lay on their back for too long. So always make sure your client is comfortable with bolsters underneath their knees, or if they're prone, you know, underneath their ankles. And if they're sidelined, you know, on the back, make sure you're supporting the back and that their spine is straight. So the next one, let me see, is patellofemoral pain syndrome. And that's a degeneration of the articular cartilage behind the knee. So you want to make sure and work the hamstrings and the quads with this one. This is common with runners, especially young people. They start getting a pain behind their knee. So it's the articular cartilage that's, you know, either tight, they pulled it. So the tendons, it starts pulling on the tendons. And remember that the quads tendon crosses the knee joint. So you want to make sure and really get in there and work the patellar tendon, which is the extension of the quads. Make sure you work the hamstrings, the adductors. And it's also known as runner's knee. So that tells you it's common in people that do a lot of running. Okay, next one is the rheumatoid arthritis, also known as RA. And this is a chronic systemic inflammation. They don't know what causes it, you know, but this is also chronic systemic inflammation that affects the synovial membranes are destroyed. And eventually the tendons start, you know, frailing and, you know, are getting destroyed too. This is the arthritis that's very crippling. This is the one that you see it gets deformed on your clients. You'll be able to tell that they become more deformed. Unlike the osteoarthritis, they're not as deformed. Their joints are not as deformed as this one, because this one destroys the synovial membranes, and it's very uncomfortable. So make sure that you massage your client gently again. This is the cause is not known for rheumatoid arthritis. It's myofascial release is very good for it. You want to stay within a comfort level of a 3 out of 10. Any of these, you know, like the rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, osteoporosis, all of these affect the bones. So you want to make sure that you're staying within a scope of practice where the client feels comfortable. You don't want to overdo it. You don't want to overstress any of the joints, especially the joints. You know, it affects the larger joints and the rheumatoid arthritis, and the small ones too, the wrists and hands, and their hands start getting very deformed. So the next one is the next one is scoliosis. Scoliosis is a S curvature of the spine. Your spine has 4 curves, okay? It has 4 curves. And the reason it has the 4 curves is kind of like the spring, like a spring. It gives you, it's for, you know, shock absorption. So this one can be functional or structural deformation of the spine. So it's like an S shape. So the functional, let's say, it's the discrepancy of your legs, or one of your hips is higher than the other one. So now it's going to accommodate to that. So your spine starts, you know, deforming, turning into an S. And the structural is vertebral rotation. That's where the vertebrae actually starts turning. So there's 2 kinds, the structural or functional scoliosis. And it's lateral, it's a lateral curvature, you know. And I know that I've seen it in swimmers. I've seen it in kids. I talked about this the last time, the kyphosis, you know, the scoliosis too. I've seen it in kids that carry the big backpacks that have bad, you know, posture. So You want to make sure that you prop your client very comfortable. Most of the time I do, when people have scoliosis, I work on them sideline to make sure that I support them with pillows on the anterior and the posterior, supporting their spine, because this can also be very painful. Like I said, I've even worked on clients that have had surgery for scoliosis, and they're still in a lot of pain even after the surgery. So make sure that you're considerate of your client and try to accommodate to their needs and how you can, you know, make them feel more comfortable. So next is the spondylosis. So the spondylosis is the it's a term to describe osteoarthritis of the spine. So this is osteoarthritis, but it's directly on the spine. So it is common in the cervicals and in the lumbar area, and it's part of the aging process or trauma. You know, somebody gets hit in a car accident, and that, you know, the spondylosis will happen along with, you know, wear and tear as we get older. And it's very important. You, the myofascial release can really help, you know, in any of these, really, myofascial release, gentle, very gentle, passive, you know, stretching is excellent. And moist heat, as long as there's no inflammation, and that will really help, you know, your clients. Next will be the sprain. So sprain, remember, sprain happens in ligaments, and strain with a T is for tendons, and tendons attach muscle to bone. So a sprain is it's a torn or overstretched ligament beyond its, you know, its range of motion. So it's usually when you're walking and you twist your ankle, or athletes, you know, the ligaments of the knee is also a common one, and it happens with sports, with falls, with twisting of the ankles. You don't want to massage it during acute inflammation. You know, you want to make sure and recommend, you know, the move, compress, and elevate. And usually you want them to elevate beyond, you know, their heart level to bring down the blood flow. So you want to use the MCE, and you want to go ahead and start doing gentle movement after the swelling and after they have healed. You don't want to do any massage while they have a torn ligament. That's beyond our scope of practice. So you want to make sure that they do have a doctor referral, or that they have been cleared by their doctor. That they have been cleared by their doctor, and that there's no chronic inflammation. And I've had clients, you know, that come in and they don't know the difference between a strain and a sprain. So like I said, usually when it's a sprain, it's a lot more severe, you know, because it's deeper. It's a separation of the ligament between the two bones. And the strain with a T, it's where the muscle meets the bone. And sometimes, you know, it's just a type 1, type 2, type 3, which is the most severe of the strains. And the same thing with the sprains, you know, when you tear the ligament completely off, that's usually when they need surgery. So make sure you stay within your scope of practice on that one. The last one is the temporomandibular disorders. And, you know, I do the intraoral massage where you wear a glove, you wear, you know, and you can go all the way back to the TMJ, to the temporomandibular joint, and you work out the muscles. This can be stress from grinding your teeth or biting down hard on your masseter. You know, really all the zygomaticus, all these muscles here really, you know, get tight from even grinding your teeth. That could be just from stress. Or it can also be, you know, like people that sleep facing down. This is common for people that sleep facing down because, you know, their head is putting a lot of pressure on that joint. So talk to your client. Always, you know, do investigation. That's what I always say. I love this part of the job where, you know, they come in with something, you're trying to figure out like exactly what's causing it. And that did happen with one of my clients that she couldn't figure out, you know, she couldn't figure out why she was having this temporomandibular disorder. And it was from her sleeping on her stomach and always having her pressing on that joint because it was only unilateral. It was only on one side. Most of the times it is bilateral, you know, like even when you go to the dentist and you've had your mouth open. I know that happened to me when I had a root canal. It's like, man, after having my mouth open for 2-3 hours and, you know, I have a smaller skeletal structure, I was really sore. I had to massage it. And if you're going to massage the temporal, you know, mandibular connection here, the joint here, make sure that, you know, that you go with a glove inside, work the masseters, the pterygoids, and stay away. Make sure you stay away from the parotid gland, the parotid gland. When you get the mumps, that's the parotid gland swelling. So that's, you know, right around here, you don't want to put pressure on that. So you can find relief with massage, with any of these, you know, right here. You can help your clients. Remember, we don't cure anything, but they do really find a lot of relief if you work on them, if they come in with any of this, especially the temporomandibular. I really find that people find instant, you know, relief from the temporomandibular disorder. So stay within your scope of practice. I hope this helps you. And this is part two of the skeletal system pathologies. And I'm going to try to take one at a time. Let me know. Leave me comments, guys. I really want your comments. I know this isn't working too well. I don't know if the TV's too small or what I need to do. You can't really see, you know, you can't really see the letters up there. I don't know if the whiteboard is better. So you guys give me feedback. Help me out here. I'm trying to do this for you guys. So comments always help. And I will do... I'm not sure which one I'm doing next. I think it's the integumentary system, but stay tuned. And until the next time, create a great day.